All right, Peter Parker, you got to go out there and get me some photos of this rumor, this hot rumor that is going on right now. You see, what we hear is happening is Batman has been canceled at issue 85, cutting us off 20 issues before the ending of Tom King's run. What did I say? Apparently, Batman has been canceled at 85 due to Tom King's run being called or cut short early, supposedly because the WB execs were not liking what he was gonna do with the Batman.
What'd you guys think? That was my J. Jonah Jameson. We're talking rumors today.
All right, so if you didn't understand through the weird accent, apparently, supposedly, the rumor going around is Batman has been canceled at issue 85, cutting Tom King runs short of 20 issues. It was originally going to go to issue 105, or 100, but including the annual. So it's going to be 105 issues total in Tom King's run. But the rumor has it that the WB executives, as a part of basically getting more involved with what's happening at DC ever since the Black Label fiasco, have decided that whatever Tom King was going to do to Batman is basically over. They don't want it to happen. His big sweeping change to the Dark Knight is basically done. We're gonna call it at issue 85. Now, this has incited quite a few other rumors and my opinion on the whole thing. So let's start with the rumors. Dan, whiteboard. Do you see my sexy pose? I was looking longingly at the sandbag over there, like I was in deep, deep thought, but all I was doing was posing for a Christian Bale Batman moment. Swear to me. Anyway, guys, so people are saying that in April, April, that the Hulk beat Batman in sales. For the first time, number one, number two, for the first time in who knows how long. Now, this is not a small accomplishment. Batman breaks about 100,000 sales every single month easily. And he's always in the top 10. In the top 10, you'll also find whatever the current event is. You'll also find whatever current Spider-Man issues are going. So it's always Spider-Man, Batman, current event. Normally, the thousands of books Batman's in, those were up there as well. And that is typically it. Books like Hulk typically fall in the 10 to 20 range, sometimes lower, depending on what the storyline is. So for the Hulk to be up here at number one, that is an incredible feat. And I don't even want to take away from that because one, I guess two, because I put up both fingers. One, I am a huge fan of the Hulk. I really am. The Hulk's one of my favorite Marvel superheroes, right up there with Spider-Man and Deadpool, okay? So for the Hulk to be up here is incredible. That means more people can get to know the Hulk the way that I do. The basically how much I am in love with the Hulk character. Now, two, that also means that this is an incredible achievement for the Immortal Hulk. The Immortal Hulk, if you've not been watching our videos or reading the comic, is a great horror take on the Hulk character. It's incredible, it's a lot of fun, it's something that I never thought I'd see, and it's a great revitalization of the character of the Hulk, and it's been going on now for, is it twice a month? At least 6 months, it may have been going on for over a year at this point. I'm not sure what the release cycle is that. It's very hard for me to follow release cycles since I read comics every single week. So, I don't even want to take that away. I love the Hulk, and the fact that the Hulk beat Batman is great, but we need to keep in mind what happened in April. You know what happened in April? Endgame. Okay, so. Endgame came out in April. So all of the Avengers books got a big bump. Iron Man got a bump. War of the Realms sold incredibly well. That also got a crazy, crazy bump. And the Hulk could have gotten a bump from that. We don't know if it's because the Immortal Hulk is that incredible or if it is because of Endgame. Now, before you all come in here and naysay and be like, oh my God, you're just salty that Batman lost. Once again, I love the Hulk. But I will say the Hulk typically fell between like ranked 10 to 20 in the sales. It was not selling poorly, guys. I want to, off the top of my head, and I may be wrong with this, I looked at all the months back to back, but I believe it was around 11 to 13 on March. So it was creeping up there. It was gaining steam. People were getting behind it. So there's a very good chance that the Hulk did this well just in general, okay? But the Endgame gave it that last bump to get it over there. What I've told everyone who has said Batman has Tom King's run has failed because of the Hulk beating it, I've told them all, I don't believe that. I really don't. And for the simple reason of this, if WB is willing to cancel Batman for one superhero outselling it, then they're very fickle because that was only 1 month. Now, if this happened repeatedly, let's say the Hulk ended up beating the Batman run for a total of, I don't know, multiple months, let's say like 6, 7, 8 months, this has been going on, then yes, I would say the Hulk beating Batman is one of the core reasons they got rid of it. But Batman went from selling like 110 to 120,000 books to about 89,000 to about 91,000. It went down a little bit, not drastically. That's still a very good sales number for a comic book. But it went down. It did go down during the Nightmare Saga, which, as I've not been quiet about, I personally felt went on way too long. And from the looks of the sales, so did many other people. So that right there, I don't think that the Hulk beating Batman is why it got canceled. Now, the second issue is the supposed rumor of Tom King was going to do sweeping changes to the character of Batman that would have stayed with him for years. And WB was not happy about this. Somebody high up in WB does not like what Tom King has been doing to the DC Universe and had decided to end the run. Now, there's a very good chance of that happening and us not knowing about it. One, Tom King went silent as of this supposed rumor. DC has not said anything, but we do know that once Black Label came out, and if you're unaware of that controversy, Black Label came out, we were able to see Batman's penis for the first time ever. By the way, he's very well endowed. I'll let you know that now before you go asking and leaving 1,000 comments. Yes, Bruce Wayne is not a small man. Anyway, Batman, that came out. Warner Brothers came down and kind of had the attitude of, what have you guys been doing to our superheroes? We're supposed to be using these as tent poles and franchises to sell movies and comic books and toys and video games. And you're now going around telling us that Batman's penis is hanging out in the world. The Batwing is for all to see. What is Batman hiding from Catwoman? Well, nothing, because she can just look it up online. He sent nudes, is what I'm guessing, you know, because that's where do you think we get those photos from? Anyway, that's been pretty open. They haven't outright said it, but we do know through the rumor mill, through everything that's been happening in the comic book industry, that after that fiasco, Warner Brothers did kind of come in and say, hey guys, we need to fix this. We need to do something. And we're gonna have more of an overall control over what is happening at DC Comics. So when that happened, I firmly do believe that this supposed cut short to issue 85, here, I'll do an 85 on here so we can see. This cut short, if it actually happened, has to do with WB not liking what Tom King was going to do to Batman. And then deciding to cut it at 85. Now, here's the problem with this. Since Tom King's run has started, it has had its ups, it has had its downs. You've got the people who love it and you've got the people who hate it. He's doing a very different thing with the Batman character. And I'm kind of in the middle on the fence on this whole thing. I like some of what he's done with the character. Sometimes I feel like it's just in there for fluff and there to stretch out the story. Case in point, the Nightmare series. Overall, I have been happy with Tom King, but he at the beginning was toting this as being a 100 issue run, which then turned into 105 if you count up all of his annuals and other books, okay? So when that was said and done, I said, okay, they've already signed him on to do all of these issues, go all the way to 105, right? So he's talking about his long game. Now, if you don't know Tom King did Sheriff of Babylon, Tom King did the Vision storyline, and Tom King did Mr. Miracle. I love Tom King's writing. But I also hated at the same time. I loved Mr. Miracle, felt he could have accomplished that in 8 issues. Loved Vision, felt he could have accomplished that in 9 issues. The point I'm making is I always feel like Tom King stretches it just a little too far, okay, for your general comic book going audience. I think he would write great novels if they would just give him that free rein. Here's Batman, write a novel and he could go to town. Now, knowing that we were going to 105, my general idea was I'll stick it out to the end. I'll read it to the end. And whatever his final punctuation is his whole story. So once it's done, then we'll know if we should hate or love this run. Because yes, he can have some cool moments, like leaving KG Beast to die, fighting Bane in his area, the Joker battle against Catwoman and Joker. All these things are epic, but there is a lot of stories in the middle that if they don't get a finale, are pointless and full of fluff. Case in point, the Nightmare series. If this gets cut short, then we have 10 issues that were just wasted. So the point I'm making is if this is official, bear in mind, this is still a rumor, but if this is canceled, then we're only at 85, you are cutting the run short. So by default, we are not going to get what Tom King was intending. And if we're not getting what Tom King was intending, that means the story has now been cut short. Imagine watching the Harry Potter movies and they took out Deathly Hallows. So imagine if Half-Blood Prince, instead of giving us Deathly Hallows, Half-Blood Prince was half the movie and the other half was just Deathly Hallows. That's what we're gonna get with the Tom King run. They're just gonna cut it short. So we'll never know if his true intentions came out, if he was truly going for it. Now, I know some people are rejoicing this because like, I hate what he's been doing with Batman. I hate what he's been doing with Wally West and the Heroes in Crisis. Well, the Wally West one I'll give you because Wally West does not have another book. But with the Batman book, a lot of people are freaking out. Oh, you're not treating it like Batman. I don't like what you're doing. Well, my problem with that is there's also Detective Comics. He's also in Justice League. Batman is also in Batman and the Outsiders now. Batman has other books where you can get the Batman you want, and we can also explore what Tom King is doing. So I get the argument against Wally because he's only in Heroes in Crisis, but the Batman argument, everyone freaking out about what Tom King's doing to Batman, guys, it has barely even affected normal continuity. They're just letting him do his thing on Batman. It's not like Batman shows up to Superman and he's like, man, I'm really struggling over the Selina thing. That hasn't happened. They've mentioned it offhandedly, you know, oh, how's Selina? Oh, right, my bad. And that's all they've done. It hasn't really affected anything. And I think that's why I'm liking what Tom King has been doing, because it does feel separate from the rest of DC Rebirth, which is fine because it kind of feels like it needs to be. If it was integrated into everything, I think I'd have a lot more problems with it. But case in point, in Justice League, Batman broke every bone in his body, and they didn't even mention that in the Tom King Batman run. So giving him just Batman to run to 105, that would have been great. I would have seen where it goes. And if we got to the ending and I'm like, dude, your ending sucked. I hated your run. That was horrendous. Well, then we could decide that at 105. But by going to 85, I can almost guarantee whatever he does is going to suck. Because we're losing 20 issues. 20. That's literally losing the last movie, the last two movies in the Harry Potter saga. That would be like Game of Thrones not having season 8 and then just ending at 7. And I know some of you would rather have that, but either way, we wouldn't have it. Like, you're cutting off the equivalent of the entire final arc, the entire final season. And what blows my mind is, okay, Warner Brothers is coming in and trying to change some things around. Why was this not, why did, when they came in December-ish, when the bat penis came out, why did they not then go, hey, let's cut it, man. Whoa, 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 whoa. We're at like issue 60. We can cut it now. It makes sense. You're this close to the finale. This close. Why are you gonna cut it this early? At this point, take it, love it or hate it, Tom King's run should finish. Just let it wrap up and then we can all decide, because forever, here's the problem for people who hated Tom King and the people who love Tom King. We will never know. We will never know. You're gonna get no conclusion to this close to the finish line. So all the people who are like, Tom King's run sucks, you can't decide that because you don't know how it wrapped up. And all of us who are like, hey, the ending was gonna decide it for me, we'll never know because it's not gonna wrap up properly. So if this rumor is true and it's cut it off early, I don't like it. I don't like it at all. Love it or hate the run should finish. And then we just pick up somebody else. Also, Barry Michael Bendis has finally got me on board with his Superman like 6 months in. The rumor has it that if Tom King has taken off the book, Brian Michael Bendis is doing Batman. What is that gonna do? What? No! Just leave him on Superman. Don't mess with my Batman, okay? Oh. Anyway, I think you guys get the point I'm going for here. It's all rumors, it's all hearsay, we don't know what's going on, and the people who hate it are rejoicing, the people who love it are getting pissed off about it, but I feel this close we shouldn't finish it. If you're gonna end it, just end it. Just call it now, and that's the end of that. Don't give him 14 issues to give us a condensed ending. But that's my opinion. But what do you guys think in the comments down below? Do you think that this should be ended, that this should be 100% wrapped up? You don't care about it getting its finale? It's not like they have another storyline lined up they're gonna go into, so... But what do you think? I want to know your opinions down below. Or do you really think that it is the Hulk beat Batman? I mean, I'm not saying that that's not it. I just don't think that's the case. And Whiteboard, what do you think? Because you don't read the Tom King run. You hate it.
I think if they're ending it early, then this whole nightmare thing was kind of a nightmare.
Yeah, 10 issues of nothing! Ah! You won't like me when I'm angry!